In this video, we want to look at how to obtain automatically the deployment file from SAS. It's a follow-up of the first part video where you were downloading the deployment assets using the public SAS portal. And you were doing some manual steps. In this second part of the presentation, we want to look at how to do that automatically. Okay, so as you know, when the customer purchases the SAS offering, he will get two things, the order email and an access to the mysas.com portal from where he can download the deployment assets. You've seen already, if you have watched the part one, that you can log in into the SAS portal, into the mysas.com portal, and click, select your version, select your cadence, and click on a button to download your deployment assets. But now, imagine for a customer who is on the monthly cadence, that he will have to do that like every month. Okay, so another way, which might be smarter and more efficient, will be to automate those steps. For that, the customer can use something called the Orders CLI. The Orders CLI is one of the SAS software GitHub projects. There are many projects available in the SAS software GitHub, and you can have a look at them. You have, again, plenty of tools, projects, for example, to automatically prepare your Kubernetes environment for deployment, automatically deploy the prerequisite, automatically deploy Viya for itself. So yeah, do not hesitate to visit this page, github.com/SAS software. The tool that we want to look at today is called Viya for Orders CLI. It is a command line utility. Okay, so you have different ways to use it. The command line could be using Go, okay, Golang, or it could directly call the executable, or it could be a Docker command line. Okay, we might want to use the container version of the tool. So the Order CLI tool is very easy to use. The only part that can be a little more complex is to configure the authentication. Because of course you need to be authenticated to access the Order artifact. Okay, so here are some requirements, of course, in terms of versions. For if you use the Go version of the tool or the Docker version of the tool, you have some requirements on this version. But yeah, again, the biggest requirement I would say is to obtain the credentials to use the tool. So you have to log in the apiportal.sas.com page, okay, and you also of course need to have a SAS profile or a SAS.com account to be able to log in into this API portal. Once you are logged in, you can click on the new app button. You provide a name and a description. You click on the plus sign to enable the API, then you click on create. And automatically, the API token will be generated for you, okay? So you will have an application ID and you will have a key, basically, a key and secret, okay? So what we need to do then is to convert the API key and the API secret that you see on the screen in Base64 encoding. So you can just run the Linux command to do that, okay? And you will have, as a result, you will have a string of characters that you need to provide to the Order CLI tool in order to download the deployment. And the way to provide those credentials could be by placing those credentials in the configuration file, or by declaring environment variables with the credentials value. Okay. Once you have done that, you can run the Order CLI command, and the Order CLI tool will download the deployment assets that you want for a specific order, a specific cadence, okay, either stable or LTS, and a specific version. Okay, so you have an example on the screen. In this case, we are using the Go method. Okay, but you could, again, you could use the Docker method or directly the executable. Okay, the pre-built executable. So the SAS software GitHub project will provide you all the documentation to do that. Okay, and that's the end of this presentation. I hope it was useful. Thank you.